trim on these trucks go in style and out of style. Back in the 70s and 80s when everybody had one, and most of them had the trim on, when they started to modify them and hot rod them, then of course you got to keep the trim on. But so many of the trucks have had the trim taken off now that the trim is back in style. So what I'll be showing you on this video is how to get back in style. Stay tuned. So I better figure where out where this trim goes. We'll get 11. The truck is 11. Then if you take a look at the piece that's on the door here, it's got a little bit of a nudge in it right there. That is from where the T-entry goes right here. So all you gotta do is just line those up and take the 11. So that's looking good. So now I'll get some really skinny tape here, so like 1/8 inch. And I'll use these lines and I'll tape it up here a couple of times and see if you can get a good feel. We'll try to fit it. I'll trim on a little bit and see how she looks. So when we put our clips in,
yes.
You see this little tab down here, take that little tab, fold that up, and there like that. So that's how it's clipped in. So in other words, it's going to be just like that. See? Flip it. So this trim piece right here is a little bit too low. So what I did is I didn't enlarge the entire hole. I just went ahead and enlarged it up a little bit. So now I'll put it back on and see where it is. You don't want to just have big ass holes on this thing because it'll make it sloppier, jiggle and move around and stuff. The top trim in place and looking good, go ahead and do our bottom. The bottom's actually a little bit easier because we have the lines here on the body to guide you there. These are going to go just a hair below that body line. They're not going to go right on it. It's probably going to be like an 8, maybe 3/8 inch below that. But you kind of want to make sure that on the fender right here, it has a little indentation that's only about a 3/8 inch or so right here. And on the front fender too, that little groove that goes right in there. Well, you want this just at the other side of that groove. So you put these pieces up here like this. And we'll put it down there and we'll make a hole and bolt it up just to fit on top. Got our trim, everything looks good. On the front of the trim and back here, it has a hole to be drilled right here, two of them. But we'll only drill those holes after we make sure that this coat is set. So now we'll pull our trim off and we'll go ahead and we'll drill the rest of the holes. And these holes, we'll drill them a little bit bigger than the other ones did. The first ones were just our trial fit. So now we can drill them just a little bit larger. And that will give us a little bit of room to maneuver when we put them back on. So when you put these back on, what you do is you get a little bit of silicone and you loop it on each one of these little connectors right here. Then when you stick it on, it'll help keep moisture and water coming in, and when the silicone dries, it'll also kind of cement the thing in place, and it won't rattle and jiggle around and move and stuff. So when you're installing these, look for minor little defects and foibles that might be on them. A little piece of the metal might be hanging down too much, and then when you put it on your nice clear coat, it'll dig right in. You don't want that. So look for any imperfections and just do whatever you need to do to get rid of them. Typically, I'll just use a 120 grit sanding wheel, and I'll just lightly sand down any rough edges or any edges that might be sticking up on here. Drilling things like this, don't drill both holes at once. Drill one hole, bolt it up, screw it in, and then do the other one. If you try to do both at the same time, then it might jiggle around and you won't get your holes lined up. So drill, screw, then. Now we'll take our skinny tape and we'll get it and we'll put it right in the middle of each one of these drilled holes. Go on now. And we'll know exactly where the plane is drilling these holes. On the bed sides right here, they're going about every 9 inches. On the door, they go about every 6 inches. And on the front fender, they go about every 9 inches. Keep in mind that you want to keep one on the ends to have it hold down nice and tight, but don't put holes where you're not going to be able to get behind and put a bolt on and the clip won't go through or what have you. The front of the spear right here kind of sticks out. It's going to have to be bolted down and hold it in really tight. In order to help us with that, there's this little bolt-on clip that looks like this. You can see it's got a point on it, just like the point of the spear. So we need to slide that in there, and then you'll have to mark exactly where the hole needs to be drilled on that. Okay, so that's how to do the trim on your truck. You stay tuned because I'm going to show you how to do the trim on the tailgate too.